right.
For an audience, they have to just be themselves and just make the audience come to them. And I've heard of people doing that, and some people do that, and that's what I've done. Because, I don't know, it's just the only thing that worked. And if you are willing to be yourself ruthlessly enough and hard enough, I think it'll work. I think it might work. Especially in the internet age, it makes things easier. You can just do it from your home.
Yeah.
And if you scream loud enough, it should work.
No, I think the better name for this panel should be, instead of finding your niche, should be creating your niche.
Mm-hmm.
Sure. I'm just scared of the word niche. It makes me feel funny in my stomach. So. Just yourself. Just be yourself, you know? That should be good enough.
Do you think maybe the problem is in the question? Like, should you be even asking this question? How do you find your niche? Is it perhaps more, what do you want to do? What do you want to achieve? Or, and then the rest will follow? Is that the... I just want one of your, like...
I'm not sure. Well, I can answer something else that we were talking about earlier. Because a lot of people say, you know, like, how are you so unique, stuff like that. But my secret is I don't watch anything else. And so, and there's a lot of things that I do, you know, like when I put captions on things or when I put images and stuff, I'm just trying to be to the point, crisp, clean, you know, quick. I'm just trying to do it what I think is a perfectly normal way. And then people tell me, like, wow, you know, you're different from everyone, but it's just because I haven't seen anything else. And sometimes I venture into watching things, and then it starts to change me, and starts to make me think I should, you know, it starts to make me think inside of other ways, and I have to stop. So my secret is just live under a rock instead.
Situation, so it was like that.
Oh yeah.
And then it was never inspired by like a TV show. It just kind of turned into a character-driven plot thing, and that's not even what I expected. It just kind of went that way.
But I'll tell you that, like, this may sound crazy, but when I really launched my YouTube channel, it went from a place where I upload, you know, maybe 10 times a year to switching overnight to a daily vlog, I felt like a little bit of a dope, because I'm like, I was 34 at the time, and I'm like this old 34-year-old guy who wants to start daily vlogging. And the only people who daily vlogged then were like Fun for Louie and Ben Brown, and daily vlogging was essentially like a point and shoot like this. And it's like, hey, I'm gonna go get a cup of coffee now. And it's like, hey, I'm drinking a cup of coffee now. And it's like, hey, that coffee was delicious. And it's like, hey, I'm drinking a coffee shop. Like, daily vlogging was nothing more than sort of a diary. And I was like, no, I want to go in and share my daily life and like have it be cinematic and have it be like a movie. And like, there was so much self-doubt there, so it just felt stupid. It felt really silly. Like, I set up a camera so I could walk out of the bedroom and have a dramatic shot. And, like, I'm just like those guys that are like, hey, I'm getting a cup of coffee now. The difference is, like, let's put some sound design under it and use the tripod. So, like, there was so much self-doubt there, and the fact that there was nobody else working in that space, let alone, like, a married father of two in his mid-30s. So I think that, like, yes, YouTube is super clicky, but, you know, if you are entering into it, it's up to you to sort of, you gotta be brave. You have to kind of define who you are. Because there's one thing that I have learned on YouTube, which should be hugely optimistic and something that's really motivating, Trevor. There's an audience for everyone on YouTube. An audience for everyone.